Morning, everybody. Ed here at Grizzly Taco, and it's a beautiful Sunday here in Las Vegas. It's actually nice and cool out, and I thought I would make some chorizo breakfast tacos today. So I'm going to be using this pork chorizo. Now, this I get from the 99-cent store, and when I go, I always buy like anywhere from 5 to 10. I like to keep it on hand because we all love chorizo in our house. So they also have pork, and they have soy if you like soy. I actually tried the soy, and it's actually pretty good, but I don't usually get it. I like the beef or the pork better. So that's what we're going to be doing today. So I'm going to set this aside. This is a frozen one. And I'm going to start out with just a little bacon grease in this pan. I'm going to use my same cast iron pan that I used for my last cooking video. I'm going to get this bacon dripping. The reason I add a little bacon dripping, it just gives it a little extra flavor to your chorizo. And if you've never cooked with chorizo before, I'm going to tell you this. Anytime you cook with chorizo, always make sure you have a lid for the pan because the grease and stuff splatters everywhere. It's a mess. So I've got a half a stick of that chorizo. I'm going to put that in here. And you want to kind of flatten it out a bit. Now this chorizo is not salty, so I will salt it here after a while. And I like to salt it before I add my eggs. So I'm using a half a stick of chorizo. I'm going to use a half a dozen eggs for this. It's already making a mess all over the place. So I'm going to put that lid on it, and I'll come back to it here in a few minutes when it's ready, and I'll show you. All right, so we've had this cooking for a few minutes, and this is what it looks like. Okay. Now the stick of chorizo is 8 ounces, and I used 4 ounces in here. And I'm going to use 6 eggs with it. So if you use a whole stick, you want to use a dozen eggs. Okay. All right. So I got them already in here. And I'll just dump those in there. Usually I would just crack them, but for video's sake, I thought I would do it the nice way. So I put them in a bowl, cracked them, and whipped them up a bit. Looks a little better that way. So I forgot to add my salt, but that's okay. So I'm going to do it now. So I'm just going to add a bit of salt. And I just want to make sure this stuff gets mixed really nice. And then we're just going to let it set and cook. Oh, didn't that look good? I know there's a lot of people who have never had chorizo, but you really should try this. There's nothing better than chorizo and eggs for breakfast. You can also fry up some potatoes, dice them not too big, or even buy like the O'Brien potatoes and fry them up, pull them out, cook up the chorizo, add the potatoes back into it once it's cooked, and put the eggs in there and mix it, and it's a heck of a breakfast taco. So I'm going to turn this up a little bit more, and I'm going to cover it there, and we'll come back here shortly. All right, so it's been cooking for a little bit, covered, and now it's starting to come together. So I'm going to stir it a little bit. I don't want to stir it too much because I like the nice big chunks. Just like that. I know a lot of people like their eggs like really well done. I'm not one of those people. So as you can see, my pan is pretty nicely seasoned because it's not sticking very well, or sticking very much, I should say. All right, so now that we got that done, we're going to cover that up and see how beautiful that is. Oh, and it smells so good. So we're going to cover that up, and I'm going to put that off on another burner. And we're going to make our tortillas. Hang on. All right, so now we're going to get the tortillas going here. So I got my omelet pan, I call it, and I'm going to put a little canola oil in there so we can heat up our shells. We're going to make some soft shells. So use corn tortillas. You can use flour if you like. I like corn because it's better for me than the flour is. Because you guys know I don't do a lot of carbs, and I did a spam video last night, and I ate a ciabatta roll. I splurged and ate it. I don't usually do a lot of carbs. So we're just going to get this nice and warm. I've got the oil on a medium to medium high heat right now, so we can get it going. And we're going to use, like I said, some corn tortillas. And I actually got these at the dollar store too. So, and Guerrero is a great brand. You can find them at Walmart. It just costs a little bit more. So let's open these up. And my daughter, Megan, is going to have some. My wife went off to work already, so she won't be joining us. So I want to make sure the oil is hot before we do this. And I'm going to make 5 taco shells here. I'm going to eat 2, and my daughter's going to eat 3. So, good stuff. And, oh, I like to test it when I can put it in there, and it starts bubbling. Then we know it's ready to go. But still got a few more seconds to go. And anytime I make shells, I try to use a tong that doesn't have a sharp edge, because it can tear up the taco shell. We don't want that. Now, I'm not going to cook these until they're crisp. I don't like crispy taco shells. I just hate them. I like soft shell. So let's see how this is working. There we go. So now it's bubbling. And I always have my plate here, and I just put a couple of paper towels on it. And see how nicely those are cooking there. And I usually hold down the center to keep the center cooking, and once it's been on for a short time like that, I'll turn them and let the other side cook, and that's when I leave the tongs here in the center. And I'll usually turn it once or twice. And I've been doing this so long that I can tell. Now, you don't want to take it out too soon because it's going to be too soft and it's going to tear. And like I said, I've been doing this for so long. Jeez. I can tell. It kind of feels a little firmer now. Well, it's been cooking. It's not. I mean, if you want to make them into tostadas, you can do that too. Just leave them in here until they're, you know, nice and crisp. I prefer the taco shells. So that's perfect. It's got a little oomph to it, so it's not so flimsy. And you just put it on the towel, drain the oil, and we're going to keep doing that. So we'll be back when I get them done. All right, so now we got our tortillas ready, and we're going to start getting these things going, preparing them, and turning them into the tacos that we are going to have for breakfast. So hang on, get going. All right, so let's assemble these bad boys. Now, I'm a firm believer in not putting cheese on tacos. It's not my favorite thing. I like cheese, but not on tacos. So we're going to take a little bit of chorizo, put some in each one of these bad boys. I'm going to make 3 of them. This is going to be for my daughter. I'm just going to have 2. All right. I'm not also a fan of lettuce in them, but when we do get them, like from Lurita's Taco Shop, they have lettuce and cheese in them. I don't mind those because it's chicken. But if it's beef, pork, or something like that, no, I don't want that. So let's get these bad boys all finished up here. So you just put so much in there, and you can put your favorite salsa in there. I've seen people put sour cream on there. I like sour cream on the taco, but I don't know. I never cared for it with chorizo. Now, I'm using some cilantro and onions. That's what I like in my tacos. I've never liked to have cheese and lettuce. This is how I get my crunch. And most places that do tacos here in Vegas, real Mexican street tacos, use cilantro and onions too. So that's how it was brought up. So now we're going to put a little green salsa on there. Now this I got from Lurita's. This is some leftover stuff I had. Okay. And then, can't leave out my favorite. What good is a taco without jalapenos? Carolina Chris, I know you like your Texas Pete's, but for this, it calls for a little something more. So I'm actually going to eat one of these, and I'll make her another one. So these are our breakfast I should say our breakfast chorizo tacos. So, what do you think? Looking good, huh? Well, let's try one and find out for sure. Let me tell you, they are good. Wow. If you haven't tried chorizo, you should try it. You'll really like it. You can find it at Walmart. You can find it anywhere. The Mexican store makes their own version. It's a homemade one. They usually have a couple different kinds that are delicious and a lot meatier. So, tell me what you think. You guys enjoy your Sunday, and me and my daughter are going to have our breakfast.